إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him a praise suitable for His loftiness and His greatness and His supremacy. He who Allah guides, none can lead Him astray. And He who is led astray, none can guide Him. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is one, alone, unique. He has no partners, no any associates in all the things that He does and in His worship. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His servant and His messenger. O you who believe, it comes في جامع الترمذي عن حريث ابن قبيصة قال قدمت المدينة He said I came to the city of المدينة فقلت اللهم يسر لي جليسا صالحا He said I asked Allah Oh Allah provide me with a righteous sitting partner فجلست إلى أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه He said I found myself sitting with the companion أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه فقلت له إني سألت الله أن يرزقني جليسا صالحا فحدثني بحديث سمعته من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لعل الله أن ينفعني به He said I sat next to Abu Huraira and I said to him Verily I asked Allah to provide me with a righteous sitting partner So inform me of a narration that you heard from the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم Perhaps Allah will benefit me with it. So you, my dear brother, listen to this narration. Perhaps Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will benefit you by this narration. قال أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه إني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن أول ما يحاسب به العبد يوم القيامة من عمله صلاته Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Verily the first thing that the servant is going to be held accountable for his actions on Yawm al-Qiyamah is his salah. فَإِن صَلُحَتْ فَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ وَأَنْجَحَ If his all his salawat are good, then he is successful and he is prosperous. وَإِن فَسَدَتْ فَقَدْ خَابَ وَخَسِرْ And his salah is deficient and corrupt, then he is a loser and he is destroyed. فَإِن تُقِسَ مِنَ الْفَارِيدَةِ شَيْءٍ قَالَ الرَّبُّ عَزَّ وَجَلُّ انظُرُوا لِعَبْدِي هَلْ مِنْ تَطُوِّعٍ فَيُكَمِّلُ بِهِ مَنْ تَقَسَ مِنَ الْفَارِيدَةِ If his salah is deficient, the Lord, the Mighty Majestic, he says, look and see if my servant has any tatawwa, any supererogatory prayers, so it can complete what is deficient from his salah. And then the rest of his actions are going to be on this method. As-salata, as-salata, ya ibadullah, as-salah, na'am ya abdullah. This is a reminder for those who are negligent in their salah. As-salata, as-salah. This is a reminder for the men. This is a reminder for the women. This is a reminder for the young. This is a reminder for the old. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حَافِظُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَالصَّلَاةِ الْوُسْطَى وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ Preserve all of your salah, particularly the middle salah, salat al-asr. Stand before Allah in obedience. الصَّلَاةَ الصَّلَاةَ This is Allah's right over you. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserves from you. He has given you life. He has given you everything that you have. You owe Him appreciation. You owe Him gratitude. You owe Him servitude. You owe Him worship. You owe Him as-salah. As-salata as-salah. Haqqullah al-ibad. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's right upon the servants. Oh, you who have abandoned salah totally. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the first thing He's going to ask you about is the salah.
Oh, you who pray some of the salah and you don't pray others of the salah, you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the first thing He's going to ask you about is the salah. Oh, you who pray just during Ramadan, or those who just pray on Yawm al-Jum'ah on Friday, you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first thing He's going to ask you about is the salah. Oh, you who pray the salah after the time has gone past. Oh, you who miss the salah because of work, because of school, because of entertainment, because of sport and play. This is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first thing He's going to ask you about when you meet Him is this salah. Ya ayyuhal insan, ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. Oh, mankind, what has deceived you about your Lord? What has fooled you about the rights of Allah that He has over you? What has deceived you? What has made you blind? What has preoccupied you from the salah? Is it your money? Is it your wealth? Ya ibadallah, there are people who are blind who make the salah. People who are sick who establish the salah. People who are crippled who establish salah. People on crutches. People on wheelchairs. People pray sitting down. People pray laying down. As-salatu as-salah. Adhaqullah. This is the right of Allah over the servants, ya ibadallah. And you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first thing He's going to ask you about is the salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ إِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِئِينَ. Seek help and seek aid. Seek assistance in all of your affairs in the life of this world. In the life of this world with patience and salah. Where do you seek help from? When do you make tawbah to Allah? When do you remember Allah? If you're negligent in your salah, وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِئِينَ. Verily is difficult except on those that are humble to Allah. So if you find yourself that you're negligent in your salah, this is a lack of humbleness from you. And this is a lack of patience from you. And this is a lack of gratitude from you. And this is a lack of appreciation from you. This is a lack of awareness from you, ya Abdullah. وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٍ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِئِينَ. Establishing salah is difficult except on those that are humble. So humble yourself, ya Abdullah. Humble yourself. This is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls out to the believers, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu ista'inu bis-sabri was-salah. Inna Allaha ma'a as-sabirin. All you who believe, seek help. Seek the help of Allah with patience and with salah. When you make salah to Allah, and you stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're standing before Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will draw you close to you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will aid you in your affairs. And move away from you difficulties and stresses. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pay your debts. And remove you from your sicknesses. This is your connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is the salah. Na'am ya Abdullah. إن النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كما جاء في أحمد من حديث حذيفة كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا حزبه عمرا صلى. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, if he was troubled by something, he would make salah. What do you do when you're in trouble? What do you do when you have concerns and considerations and troubles and problems? Where do you turn to if you abandon the salah? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم كان إذا همه عمرا صلى الاستخارة. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he wanted to make a decision, was considering about something, he used to pray to raka'a al-istikhara. Can the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he talab al-madr, sallu al-istikhara. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he wanted rain from the sky, salla, he used to make the salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he came to the masjid, can you salli? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to make the fard in the salah. But if he went home, he made ar-rawatib in the house. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تجعلوا بيوتكم قبورا صلوا في بيوتكم. Don't make your houses like graveyards. Pray in your houses. الصلاة الصلاة يا عباد الله حق الله على العباد. Maybe this is the problem that you have in your life. Maybe this is why you're so short-tempered. This is why you have such lack of sabr. This is why you have so much anxiety. This is why you have so much depression. This is why you don't get along with your family. This is the reason why you have problems in your life. because a salah has fawaid and has benefits from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa rabbuna subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar. Really, it's the salah that prevents from falling into indecencies and wrongdoing. What's going to protect you from the haram? Your identification, the fact that your name is Abdullah, the fact that your name is Muhammad, what is going to protect you from the haram? As-salatu as-salah, haqqullah al-ibad. This is Allah's right on top of the servants. Wa fawaiduhu kathira. The benefits of it are enormous. Na'am ya Abdullah. When Nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it gives a beautiful example for the servants. For the believers, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that it comes from the hadith of Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, Ara'aytum law anna nahran bibabi ahdikum yagtasilu minhu kulla yawmin khamsa marratin هل يبقى من دنره شيء؟ قالوا لا يبقى من دنره شيئا. قال هذا ذلك مثل صلوات الخمس يمحو الله بهن الخطايا. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, inform me, tell me, if there was at the door of one of you all a river flowing and he washes in it 5 times a day, is there going to be any dirt remaining on his body? They said there's nothing going to be remaining on his body from any dirt. He said this is the example of the 5 salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipes away the sins. How do you make tawbah to Allah if you're deficient in your salah? When do you turn to Allah? When do you complain to Allah? When do you turn to Allah? When do you make tawbah to Allah? When do you call out to Allah? If you're deficient in your salah, if there was at the door of one of you a river, it's at the door, it's right in front of you, it's bayna yadayk. How easy it is. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he was traveling, he would shorten the salah from 4 rak'ahs to 2 rak'ahs. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he was traveling, he would join dhuhr wal asr, even at the time of dhuhr, or even at the time of asr. If the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was traveling, he would join Maghrib with Isha, even at the time of Maghrib, even at the time of Isha. مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ يَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. What is it that has deceived you about your Lord, and that you don't turn to him, and that you don't establish the salah as he commanded? نعم يا عبد الله. وَإِبْنِ مَسُودٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ كَانْ يَقُولُ تحترقون ثم تصلون الفجر فغسلتها. They're burning, meaning in their sins and in their disobedience. Then they pray Salatul Fajr and it wipes it all away. ثم تحترقون ويصلون الظهر. Then they're in sin and they're in disobedience. They fall into disobedience. They fall into the haram. Then they pray Salatul Dhuhr and it wipes it away. ثم تحترقون ثم يصلون العصر. وتحترقون ويصلون المغرب وحقد العشاء. يا عباد الله الصلاة الصلاة.
الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يقول الرب عز وجل كما في الحديث وإن تقص من فريضته شيئا قال الرب عز وجل انظروا لعبدي هل من تطوع فيكمل به من تقص من الفريضة. If his salah is deficient, it's going to be said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to say, look and see if he has any faridah, if he has any tatawwa', if he has any nafila, if he has any supererogatory of the salah to fulfill and complete that which is deficient from his salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to look at your salah. You're in dire need of it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes this clear as he says, wa aqimu salah wa atu zakah. وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُم مِّنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. نَعَمْ يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ. Establish the salah.
and pay the zakah, and that which you gather up for yourselves, and that which you put forward from good deeds, you're going to find it with Allah. What are you going to find in your book, Ya Abdullah? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha wal tanzur nafsun ma qaddamat lighad. Oh, you who believe in Allah, and let you look at what you put forward for tomorrow. What did you put forward for your grave? What did you put forward for yawm al-qiyamah? وَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي. The one in the hellfire, he's going to be regretful. And he's going to say, only if I had put something forward for the future, Nam Ya Abdullah. مَا أَحْوَجَنَا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ. How much we are in need of the salah. Don't fall short of the salah. Don't be negligent in the salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has threatened those who are negligent in the salah with a severe punishment. When Nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, bayna ar-rajuli wa bayna ash-shirki wal-kufri tarku as-salah. That which is between a man and from falling into shirk and falling into kufr is abandoning the salah. What is going to hold you fast upon Islam? Your identification card, your name, your birth certificate. What is going to hold you fast on Islam? Don't fall short in your salah. Don't waste it. Don't be negligent in it. يَقُولُ رَبُّنَا سُبْحَانُهُ وَتَعَالَى فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفًا. Then they came a generation after him. After them, أَضَاءُ الصَّلَاةِ وَاتَّبَعُ الشَّهَوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّاهِ. They came a generation after them. They wasted the salah, meaning they didn't fulfill it as they were supposed to. وَاتَّبَعُ الشَّهَوَاتِ. And they followed their desires. And they're going to taste the punishment. هذا من كلام ربنا سبحانه وتعالى وربنا سبحانه وتعالى يقول ويل للمصلين. Well to those. Well, ويل means it's a threat with punishment. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is threatening everyone who can hear this. ويل للمصلين. Well to those who pray. الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون. Those who are negligent in the salah. Negligent in the salah means maybe they don't pray it at the correct time. Or maybe they don't even pray it correctly. Or they don't pray it with khushu'ah. And they pray. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, waylun lil musallin. Woe to those who pray. What about those who don't pray? Waylun lil musallin. Woe to those who pray. They're making salah. And because they're deficient. And because they're negligent in salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is threatening them with a punishment. What about those who abandon the salah? And they pray some of their salah. Or they just pray on yawm al-jum'ah. Wail al-luck, ayyuha tarik as-salah. The one who has abandoned salah, wail. Na'am ya ibadullah. Wa yaqul nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man taraka salat al-asri faqad habita amaluh. Whoever has missed salat al-asr, all of his deeds are null and void. What about the one who leaves all the salah, one salah? فجاءنا بالدرداء عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من ترك صلاة العصر متعمدا حتى تفوته الوقت فقد حبط عمله. The one who has left and missed صلاة العصر on purpose until all the time has gone away, all of his deeds are null and void. يا عباد الله حافظوا على الصلاة. Preserve the salah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will preserve you. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his protection, his aid, and his assistance. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استوى. استو الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمي الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مصفوء فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر سمي الله لمن حمده
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.